In this video, we're gonna see how to effectively maintain the transducer of an ultrasonic system.
The explanation in this series is provided by the technicians, the paramedical technicians working at Rainier de Graaf Hospital located in Delft. Here he starts by booting up the ultrasonic machine.
This is an ultrasound for pediatric use. That's small transducers, cardiac transducers, and one convex transducer. You can select the transducers with these buttons. This is the convex. You can see that when I touch the face, you can see an ultrasound image. First of all, I always start to place the TCG sliders in the middle position. There's a small click, you can feel it when you slide it. When you do this, you have always the same starting point when you check the transducers. And every year we take a picture of the transducer without any gel. And to confirm it's the same as the year before. Therefore, mostly this type of transducer we make a picture at 90%, but if then you can count the rings. When the transducer gets old, the face can harden, and then you have poor image quality. And if you place this on 100% as the maximum, you can count the rings. So therefore, we always a bit less. At 90%, you can count the rings, and then we freeze the image and we acquire the image. And this picture we archive in our system for reference. This transducer has a number of crystals. Each crystal transmits and receives. If one of the crystals is failing, then you see a black line. To make sure all the crystals are working, you can check with this and go over the lens of the transducer, and if there is a crystal fading, you can see clearly the image will turn around that point. This transducer is 100% good, so you don't have any problems with this one. We have a transducer which is damaged. It is very hard to see, but it can be a big problem. There's a small hole in the face of the transducer, and at that point it can become electrical unsafe to work with. Transducers are evoked with high voltage, and if the high voltage comes at this point outside, it goes to the patient and can go through the patient to ground, and the patient can feel that. When patients are traumatic and are in shock, they cannot respond to pain. If I do it with me, then I'm scared, and then it's no problem. But if patient is in coma or shock, then it can be a big problem.